A provocative move by China. It's conducted a second day of military drills around Taiwan. The huge display of force involving numerous aircraft and ships appeared very much like combat rehearsals. The US is monitoring the situation, but it's no coincidence the drills have happened just days after Taiwan's president met with American lawmakers. And the US has confirmed its commitment to deliver more weapons to Taiwan.
Taiwan's strength, openness, and resiliency is the envy of communist China. For the CCP fears its own people more than anything.
Well, Peter Hatcher is the international editor for the Sydney Morning Herald and The Age. He joins us now. Peter, it's not all that unusual for political leaders to meet lawmakers from other countries. Why is China responding like this?
Well, the way that the Beijing government sees it, any contact between the US and the government of Taiwan at a high level is part of an American plan to, in China's words, use Taiwan as the front line of containment of China. And of course, China also tries to intimidate Taiwan, to warn it against declaring independence, making any sudden moves, and also it's designed as a warning to the US to stop sending new arms and support to Taiwan.
So does this in some ways help the argument that the democracy leaders in Taiwan make?
Yeah, the more belligerent China is, the more threatening China looks, it reinforces the argument, exactly as you say, that the Taiwanese government uses to point to China and say, look, it's a real threat, it's a dangerous threat. And of course, China uses this for its own internal purposes as well. The Chinese government is using this in propaganda clips set to stirring music to show the might and power of China.
And why does this matter so much for us here in Australia? Taiwan is quite a long way away from our borders. How does it impact us?
Yeah, well, you know, if and when this does escalate and push comes to shove and there is a shooting war, there'll be a big argument here saying that this is not Australia's business. But on the other side, there'll be probably the dominant argument politically that it is Australia's business, that apart from the fact that Taiwan is a democracy and Australia should be supporting other democracies, that if China were to take Taiwan, it would allow China to push US forces, US bases out of the Asia Pacific entirely. And that therefore the US will fight against China, will fight to preserve Taiwan as a separate entity. And that will also draw in Japan because Japan says it's an existential threat to Japan. So Australia would be expected to fight with its ally, the US, and its major friend and partner, Japan, in that circumstance.
Peter Hatcher, thank you very much.
Pleasure, Hamish.